Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Dragon Quest II. I am Rueful, playing this game for you.
Woo!
Off screen, I got a hold of a light sword for Rueful, just because Roto's sword is garbage. And I also got a power shield build for Kane. And thus in the doing, Kane also hit level 17, which has learned him the Step Guard spell. Hoorah! Those are the only particular items of significance. But of other significance... Hello, sir! Angel's Robe of Water is complete. And, well, he suggests we dress the beautiful woman in it. I'll be honest, Angel's Robe of Water give a fair argument for anybody to be wearing it. Better armor than the armor of Gaia. In fact, the Angel's Robe of Water is plus 65. It would look well on anybody. But no matter, we shall actually give it to the lovely lady. The Angel's Robe of Water decreases damage from breath weapons and magic, and also renders its wearer immune to poison swamps and their equivalents. But for the moment, let's not worry about that. Let's instead worry about the tower. Tower of the Moon! Yeah, this one. Or in theory, here we will find the Moon Fragment. The major thing which we will find is plenty of loot. Hoorah! Oh yes, and noteworthy opponents. Ow. I think we got that shield. Money! We'll pick up that chest later because those are the stairs we need for progress. Over here, however, are stairs for loot. Like loot. Yay! Get rid of the puppet man and try to put one of the orcs to sleep. Hooray! Of course you'd go after the sleeping one. Ow. I suppose I should bring up that there is a special use for the light sword. That is that if you use it in battle, it'll emulate the surround spell. It did this in 8-bit, too. I just never knew about it. That's, yeah, Rufel's got other things to be doing, so we might not see the sword used for that purpose. Just gonna hope these puppet men don't dance all my magic points away. Like that. Jerks! Yay! You keep dancing for Rufel, I'm fine with that. Yay! Up we go! And then up some more! For more treasure! And of course, because it's the correct path. Never mind the small details, though. Alright! Let's go through the doors! And all the way down to the ground floor. Common trend in these towers, you climb most of the way up the tower so you can find your way back down to the bottom.
When the moon becomes full, so too will the oceans. All is decided. This is the Tower of the Moon. Now it is best to open that treasure box. That is decided. Okay.
So we have the moon fragment, the item we actually came for. Now we have this, let's make our way to the top of the tower. The Hell's Messenger, also known as an evil clown. Wow. Really helping those guys out. Apart from increase, the Hell's Messenger can melee really hard, or it can cast Firebane. Firebane is painful. We don't want that. Take that, punk! Ow. Jerks. Be a little bit more concerned about poison if it actually did something during combat. Fortunately, it doesn't. It's just an annoyance after combat. Yay! Ah, no new spell. I'll take care of that girl. Continue back to the roof. Take that. Oh! Jerk! The enemies en route to the roof are actually kind of dangerous, so, pay to take them seriously. But we also just might not meet anything. You can run into metal babbles up here. I'm not going to, but you can run into them. Two off that. See if you can put one of these guys to sleep. That's a problem. A jerk? Oh. I knew about their increase. I was caught unawares by the decrease. Fortunately, Gargoyle B is sleeping. Now he's dead. Ow. Yay! Woo! We have a helmet! Sail fodder! Which is good, because I still have a use for money. Largely in the form of getting more power shields. Came all the way up here for a wizard ring! Or a prayer ring, whatever you want to call it. So, let's get out of here and make use of that moon fragment. Ha-ha! Alright! Sell some junk! Just to get out of the way! Plus iron helmet! It's +6! And only the Prince of Laurasia can equip it. That doesn't really stack up very well against the Helm of Roto. Go figure. Oh well, let's catch some sleep. Now to set out for some spot out in the middle of the ocean. Not really, then. Those are the real directions we have to work with. I guess more appropriately, that spot just to the... just to the, southwest of Drakendor. I believe that's what the name of the place is called. Either way, it's largely due south. I have to admit, I'm surprised these guys didn't just run. Take that. Wish to really inconvenience me. Oh, there it goes! You'll stick around for another round to die, or... Yes, he is! Away with you! Jerks! Right. Like that. Away with you. Really should have just had Maria defend. Oh well. No sense worrying about that now. Now we need to worry about not getting lost. That shrine will be relevant once we've gotten all 5 crests. Until then, it is absolutely useless. Aha! Those shoals mark our destination.
away with you!
It's a very powerful fragment to whip the tides that much. Oh well. In we go. And make good use of the step guard spell. The magma doesn't really do that much damage, but it does do damage, which will ultimately result in the spending of a lot more than just one magic point. Fancifully enough, the step guard spell will actually remain active until it's needed. Hopefully we can deal with these guys before they set about trying to dance away my magic points. Hooray! In fact, it's actually surprising just how long the step guard spell will remain in effect. In fact, on 8-bit, it would actually be preserved through saving the game and turning it off. She is just a friend. Oh, that could actually be a problem with those bloody hands. Just since I need to deal with that eyeball. So Rufel should be able to deal with the eyeball on his own. Knock on wood. That. Welcome back to the battle, Maria! It will actually do more damage just by attacking. That. Ow. They're off, jerks. Kind of lost my train of thought, but yeah, step guard's awesome. Oh gosh. Oh, at least we got him out of the way. Wow. These things are very resilient to magic. Good thing they're a lot less resilient to being pummeled. Try not to get hurt, Maria. Boys will handle this eventually. Hot. Woo! What we got? Yay! $75. Oh well. Let's take this magic nut and be on our way. Deeper into this cavern. Now down to the south there's a treasure chest. It has... well, it kind of has nothing in it. It's a trap treasure chest that will poison in the person who opens it. In this case, it would be... that would be Rueful. Okay. What are you even doing in here? No matter. I have a taiga. It's chosen to pick on Maria, it would seem. Good work, boys. Gonna need to keep her health up. In case we run into more than one killer tiger. Yay! Now everyone has a prayer ring. Though one of these people clearly don't need it. Step out to explore. Hello, sir. The what now? Okay. Ah, I see. Ah, thank you. What if I had found it? Thank you, sir. Uh-oh. Let's get rid of the orc. Darn it, Kane, I said get rid of the orc, not miss the orc. Ow. Words. There, see? Why couldn't you do that last round? Yeesh. Always gotta complicate everything, don't ya? Pummel! Keep guarding, girl. Alright. That's the guy who told us about how this place was formed. Alright, what we got here? Those stairs lead to a dead end. That box is full of poison darts. Other than that, it's empty. That leads to a dead end. This box we want. Hooray! That box there has some magic armor that we'll want. Though it is mostly just sail fodder. That. Clear off. This is the floor where things actually really start to get dangerous. Doesn't have anything to do with the graphical glitches. The danger is found from those killer tigers. But we're almost there. An empty box over there, so it's the only box on the level, so let's just go down to the Temple of Fire. Once again, the difficulty has stepped up. Take that, punks! Pummel! There are also some skeleton warriors around that I'll be happy if I don't run into. Hello, sir!
Insolent fools who disgrace the Temple of Fire! You'll sacrifice your souls to our gods!
Right.
I have two messengers.
This could prove painful. Oh, wait. Oh! Okay, it proved painful. But clearly, the Angel's Robe of Water offers a lot of magic defense.
This can't be, Lord Hargon.
We did all that for the statue. This evil statue. Which we're going to take and leave. And next time, we'll find a suitable place to actually put this thing to use. We'll see you then. Later.